diabetes, they are usually we try with the insulin, we try to control their sugars between fast 70 to 90 for fasting stage, and are below 140 or below 120
Let me get this clear, doctor. Yes. You are saying that in gestational diabetes, the normal levels are itself lower.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So it comes to fasting sugar should be between 70
to 90. Yes.
90. And postprandial should be
below 140 for 1 hour, and for 2 hours it should be below 120, according to DIPSI guidelines that we follow. Yeah.
Now, doctor, does that not make it management of diabetes very difficult, more difficult than usual?
Of course. There in gestational diabetes, that's why, there are only one drug is allowed, that is metformin. Other than that, we can use the insulin. So, in gestational diabetes, majority of the female need to take 3 or 4 shots of insulin in a day.
Correct.
Just to control that, bring out that sugar.
Correct.
And the situation is even worse in the last 3 trimesters. So in the last 3rd trimester, the situation is even worse.
So
there are certain females who goes more than 100 units of insulin in a day.
Okay.
In gestational diabetes, normally there are certain things, those who have a long-term diabetes or insulin resistance, they are obese, those females might have to increase insulin, may go up to more than 100 or 120 units.
So, does that mean that the hypoglycemic levels also would be different for gestational?
Yes, of course. For gestational, in gestational female, the hypoglycemia is below 50 roughly. So, we won't consider it below 70. They normally get hypoglycemic symptoms below 55, I think.
And does it ever happen that, you know, they pass out, like in case of normal diabetic who are on insulin? They pass out because of their hypoglycemia?
I think that is very rare. When we monitor this, we try to keep it below roughly around 70 to 90. So we try to bring it below 90. We don't focus on getting below 70. So we always try to monitor. See, I don't have any incidences where there is no such case at present. I do not have any hypoglycemia case in the fasting state with any gestational diabetes female at present. So we monitor that.
No, but then doctor, that is
we gradually uptitrated the insulin doses. So we try to minimize the hypoglycemia. They're very rare, I think. In gestational diabetes, it is very rare hypoglycemia.
But doctor, the point is that most of them would be doing their management of blood sugar at home.
Yes.
So, do they get episodes of hypoglycemia then?
Of course, they need to reduce the dosage. Yes.
Okay. Now, when it comes to age, what do you think would be the perfect age, looking at the practicality of it, for getting married and having children for women, according to you?
That's a tricky question, I think. But it's still nowadays we are actually post 30, I think majority of the genetic disorders and other complications also increases. So ideally you should be pregnant by 25, I think, in my opinion.
So the last child that you should have is at the age of 25?
At the age of 30 max.
30.
I feel that is the good thing.
That's a great bit of information for our people, for our readers. Okay, now let me now get into the problems dealing with gestational diabetes on the kids. Okay, what kind of effects do you see of gestational diabetes on the kids of mothers who have gone through that ordeal?
In the later life, they have an increase in the gestational diabetes. If sugars are not under control in the first trimester, there is a possibility of miscarriages or abortions. In the second trimester, there are more chances of getting neurological defects in the child if the sugars are not controlled during the gestational period. If the second trimester sugars are high, there is a more possibility of neurological disorders, especially anencephaly, hydrocephalus.
So, as a diabetologist, what would be your recommendation to people, to women who are going through gestational diabetes? For their children?
See, they need to keep their sugars well controlled. They have to frequently monitor their sugars. They have to focus more on their diet and exercise.
I was talking about post gestational diabetes, what kind of care they should give to their children?
proper nourishment early. There should be a proper breastfeeding for first 6 months.
Okay.
There would be
breastfeeding can actually matter a lot.
Yes, of course. In normally first 6 months are the essential for the baby to be breastfed basically. So mm-hmm. it is a good nutrient and other sources and immunity basically for the child.
Recently there was a report which said that autism also can be prevented if there is breastfeeding.
Yes, there are lots of other things
so
also.
So many things. So
breast milk in the normally first 6 months of exclusive breastfeeding is always healthy for the baby.
Okay. Doctor, what happens to what's the percentage of miscarriages in case of gestational diabetes? That must be quite a rare thing. Simply because the compliance is so good.
Yes, yes, yes. Of course, the compliance is very good. Nowadays, there is a quite awareness, mm-hmm. and people are regularly, especially if the gestational females are taking regular insulin shots and all. So now there is a, I think that miscarriage and abortion percentage has decreased sufficiently nowadays.
Okay.
Even in metro cities, I think there are good caregivers actually. So.
Okay.
So it is well monitored at present.
Actually, the entire family is involved. So
yes, yes, yes.
Okay. Now, when it comes to PCOD, how is that related to gestational diabetes? And what would be the prevention measures that you would recommend?
In case of polycystic ovarian syndrome, normally those females those who have a PCOS, they have a increased androgens basically.
Okay.
in their blood system. Basically that PCOS develops due to the hyperinsulinemia. There is an insulin resistance. PCOS is a pre-diabetic condition. So normally those females, the PCOS females are generally they are obese. There are non-obese PCOS as well. They have irregular cycles basically.
Okay.
There is a facial hair growth, there is a acne.
It is a period cycle.
Period cycle, yes.
Oh,
the period cycles are irregular, and that's
so that's one of the symptoms.
Yes, that is one of the symptoms. We will diagnose the PCOS with the sonography. We'll see the follicles, the size, the bulky ovaries, and then we can decide if that patient has a PCOS or not. PCOS is a pre-diabetic condition basically. Those patients who have a PCOS, they have a very high chances of developing gestational diabetes and later diabetes type 2 in their further life. There are increased, so it is a PCOS is a very is a risk factor, but it, at the proper time, if we modify their lifestyle, basically the weight and the physical activity increases, exercise increases, and probably it is a reversible condition. So we can control the outcome basically, and in majority around I think 30% of the reproductive group females has a PCOS nowadays in metro cities at least. So it is a major cause of infertility nowadays.
Like it's known that every family has a diabetic.
Yeah.
So essentially what would you tell them to as a preventive measure to women who are in the marriageable age or in the childbearing age?
Staying lean is a kind of a prevention from type 2 diabetes. Increasing age, genetic factor, ethnicity, that these factors cannot be modified. But what we can modify is a physical activity, environmental factor basically. Weight we can control. We can start healthy eating basically. Diet can be controlled. Physical activity. These two modalities we have. Other than that, we should avoiding addictions like smoking or alcohol abuse. Other than that, we can restrict. We can keep a good control of hypertension. These all factors need to be can be modified.
And also there would be thyroid issues involved?
Yes, yes. Normally, majority of the females there is an increased chances of hypothyroidism. Majority of the females are hypothyroid basically, and the prevalence is increased.
Especially which means that the hormone is lesser, thyroid hormone is lesser.
Yes, T3, T4 is less.
Okay.
T3, T4 is the, and it is majority of them are autoimmune types. So there is a...
The body itself is...
Itself destroying the gland.
Correct.
So...
Just like type 1.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Yes. Okay. So hypothyroidism, especially Hashimoto's, that okay. is very common nowadays.
And what again would be the recommendation to such women who have all these
things? They need to control the weight as well. For autoimmunity, there is not many things which can do. We can do. So we can only supplement the thyroid hormone itself, T4. What we take thyronorm or the thyroxine, it is a T4
injection.
So we are just no. It is a pill.
Okay.
You need to take it empty stomach, and that could be a. That depends. If autoimmunity is there, there could be a lifelong treatment, or there could be a, in case of thyroiditis, or there could be a 6 months or a yearly treatment. It depends on the
20 seconds left for this session. Tell us, what would be your recommendation to women who are getting married or probably getting pregnant? What would be your recommendation to them, essentially, to avoid all these related issues?
Regular checkup of their blood sugars, basically. Regular checkup before the planning for pregnancy, they should check for the thyroid disorders, thyroid mm-hmm. routine profile,
mm-hmm.
the healthy diet, and regular exercise is the key to control all these disorders. So these are metabolic changes. It is only due to the lack of physical activity. So basically, nowadays in the metro cities, majority of us have a sedentary lifestyle. So basically, that needs to be changed.
And when they are pregnant, they are usually told not to move around much. So that is another.
No, that is not correct actually.
That's not correct at all.
Yes, that's not correct actually. A pregnant woman can move around. Obviously, she should not go for the strenuous exercises and all. But physical activity is must, I think, for everybody.
No, we have even noticed in villages, women who work in the farm, they get labor, bear a child. That kind of situation also
yes.
we have seen. It's amazing, you know, how nature works. Thank you so much, sir, on that. Thank you.